And let's talk about Russia now with Francis Scarr, who follows Russia for BBC Monitoring. And Francis, Kerry was talking about self-censorship. Is that a similar situation in Russia? Is that how the citizens of Russia approach things?
I think with Russia, there is a large proportion of the population, unfortunately, that is willing to consume the extremely anti-Western, anti-Ukrainian narratives that are being put out by the state media. The polling we have suggested around two-thirds of people still get most of their news from state TV. Just a few days ago, a major propagandist was threatening to fire nuclear weapons at the US and sink the British Isles, in his words, if the West were to deploy regular troops to Ukraine. That said, there have been a whole raft of kind of repressive laws which have been introduced over the last few years, and especially since the invasion of Ukraine just over 2 years ago, to essentially make telling the truth a crime, especially when it concerns criticizing the Kremlin or criticizing Russia's actions in Ukraine. And of course, against this backdrop, many people are afraid of expressing their views, and self-censorship has definitely increased in that sense. And what we're seeing now, increasingly so, is that almost consumption of this kind of independent reporting, which is considered legal, is becoming a risk for people.
And what about social media? I mean, I think for years we've been aware that the Russian opposition has been using social media, but is it also something now that's used by the state successfully?
That's definitely true. What we've seen historically is figures in the opposition and independent media who have been essentially deplatformed from traditional forms of media, such as TV or newspapers, turning to social media. We saw Alexei Navalny, for example, using YouTube to publish these extremely slick videos accusing various officials of alleged corruption, for example. But especially since the invasion of Ukraine, on Telegram in particular, one of the social media platforms, a number of so-called military bloggers or these kind of pro-war voices who are providing these minute-by-minute updates of what's happening in Ukraine have really proliferated on Telegram and garnered hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of views. And even though ostensibly social media platforms such as Facebook, Twitter and Instagram are blocked in Russia, you have officials from the Russian government who are using them to put out and amplify these anti-Western messages.